Jordan Marshall, junior from Hamilton, Georgia. Trying to run away from that backside pressure. And they run him down.
He's also got a guy, it'd be a guy from time to time, they'll draw Ricky June in coverage.
Second down for the Jackets. The pitch, Green. Goes about sidelines for Paul Johnson, fourth among active coaches in career victories with 178. And his team in the ACC, it is a small sample size, but best on third down of the conference. See what they can do here. That ball's on the turf, up for grabs. It appeared that Pittsburgh covered, and they
put yourself on schedule where you have a chance to put first downs on the board.
Georgia Tech fumbled on its first possession. Here's Benson going up the middle.
Dismissed from the team, and Benson has surfaced at 124 yards against Tennessee.
Benson again. Yards rushing in that opening game against Tennessee. So Benson again.
Rushed for almost 3,600 yards in high school.
Third and short, Quay Searcy. Stop near midfield and driven back.
Paul Johnson does it many times. He's going to go for it.
Just the second time this season, though, that Georgia Tech has gone for it on fourth down. Missed it the first time. Lynchner on the left side. He's going to have it for the Yellow Jackets inside the 35. Boy, whistle's going to stop this play as Benson.
Got a guy sitting to my left that is interested in that 7 o'clock game. Really interested to see what happens with Duke and North Carolina, the earliest they've ever played in an ACC schedule.
Duke head coach David Cut.
Schedule. He just runs his B-back for 6 yards.
Best in the nation. Over 372 yards rushing per game. Marshall down the sideline. Stays in bounds. Dives for the end zone. Touchdown, Marshall.
Slinging it all over the yard. Duke off to an excellent start.
Tied at 7. Under 5 minutes to go in the first quarter, it's Benson on the run. Benson got 7 yards on that carry for the sophomore from Marietta, Georgia. Marshall diving forward. He's got a first down.
And the motion is correct. There's a lot of things going on in this option attack that he has to account for.
This time they keep it simple and give it to Benson.
One play, it didn't work, but they are usually good on the angles with the toss.
Yeah, and get ready. The pass is coming. He's going to tee up one of his big receivers. And I mean big. They're all about 6'3".
Georgia Tech is 0 for 2 on third down. Marshall calls his own number up near midfield. And a first down for the Yellows.
How about this Marshall kid?
Yeah, when I talked to him this week, he mentioned, yeah, I can run the football, I can throw it. But my toughest is what I really want to be good with my teammates.
Toss play to J.J. Green, D.J. Shockley, and that's going to
be hard to stop. Ball on the pin, 39.
So Green gets a breather. We come back now with Jerry Howard. Here, don't settle for less than a Honda. Lee came to the sideline for Georgia Tech. As the Yellow Jackets operate on second down. This is Benson.
It'll be about a school, and they shut down the run game, and all they did was score three touchdowns. Look at the safety starting to creep down now. All the way down near the line of scrimmage.
Benson's got a first down.
Believe me, Coach Johnson seeing that now.
Defensively up front, there's not a lot of pressure on their hands to fire up the ball. They kind of like trying to read and react to everything from down below.
10th play of the drive. They swing it out to Ricky June. But a couple of Panthers can
time
of
possession. Right now, Georgia Tech's having the better of it.
Marshall had it knocked away, scooped it back up. Got to the 20, dances up, but he did get 5 yards.
Jackets really good in the red zone. Touchdown ratio.
Marshall, the spin to the 5. And down close to the goal line.
He's not doing that anymore.
Georgia Tech takes it into the end zone. It's Marshall from a yard out. His second TD of the legendary head coach in 1988. And the Yellow Jackets hold a 14-7 lead in possession of the football here in the second quarter. Marshall over the middle of the field. Too far. Looking for Searcy. Our first and 10 line brought to you by your Honda dealer of the Carolinas. This year, don't settle for less than a Honda. Second down, Georgia Tech. J.J. Green. Green's got a first down out.
To the B-back, do you keep it, do you pitch it? He's on point right now.
First and 10, Georgia Tech. Benson crosses the 40 to the 41. He got
a little bit because really Marshall missed the throw. If he hits, so seriously, he's got a chance to score.
Benson is driven backwards.
You have to get off blocks because they get to the second level too fast. As soon as that happened, cornerback Devontae Maggis came over and said, hey, we got this.
Let's see if Marshall has this on third and six. Cannot elude the Pittsburgh.
Talk to him early this week. He said he watches Tavon Austin. That's who he emulates. He watches him before every single game, his highlight game. And that's what he looks forward to. He said he wants to be similar to Tavon Austin.
Back on schedule and run the ball. They've done a nice job here on first down.
Marshall the pitch. Clinton Lynch. Three Panthers
on the defensive side.
Getting a little feisty here on third and short for Georgia Tech. Marshall goes through the line, just shy of the 40. But the ACC Network Game of the Week presented by Mellow Mushroom next week. Syracuse and NC State as we go back to Raleigh, North Carolina. Marshall's pass floats into the secondary and is intercepted by Dane Jackson. There is a flag. In fact, there's two behind the play as Marshall was knocked to the turf after the release.
Yeah, it's going to be roughing the passer, Tom. Excellent job of playing it in the back end by Pitt, but they're going to get a roughing the passer here.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense, number 19. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Yeah, poor decision.
About the football at about the 46 of Pittsburgh. First and 10, Georgia Tech. That ball is on the turf. It's scooped up. Avante Maddox has it for Pittsburgh. Maddox up past the 40-yard line. Pennsylvania. And the Panthers hit a field goal as time ran out to beat Georgia Tech. So we said we expected a close ball game. That's exactly what we've gotten.
Well, good hard penetration right there by Pitt defensive.
As the game is over, in-depth analysis of this game and other ACC games from our studio crew. Victory formation. Marshall's pass. It is caught up near the third.
In his career last year, 17 yards a touch.
Benson up to the 40.
Penetrating. Get the pass play down the field.
Play never developed for Marshall. Marshall delivers, but this one sails. 4 of 7 on third down. Third and 10 for Georgia Tech. They set up the screen. Benson trying to get away from a couple of defenders around his
isolation. Bubble over this. Oh, he pulled him off.
Even run a play. They have the full complement of timeouts to work with. With 2:22 to go, Marshall wants to throw it. Searcy, incomplete.
As soon as the ball was there and just got his hands up to be able to catch that football, was even more spectacular.
Benson. Benson's got a first down.
Most people's minds is just a simple dive play, but it's one of their bread and butter, and they pick up the first down.
Benson bounces off a couple of Panthers, gets right there
in days, and now here's Benson running the football.
Day 15 carries 88 yards. Lowers his head into the line. That's
to change its schedule a little bit to allow that to happen.
First and 10, Georgia Tech. 107 to go. They've got three timeouts to work with. Benson. This will be the 12th play of the drive on second and 6 for Georgia Tech. Just over a minute to play in this half. Marshall looking for a seam. Tries to get around that corner and goes out of bounds near the 5. In the second quarter, Georgia Tech and Pittsburgh tied at 14. Benson, close to the goal line and in. The rushing touchdown, Kervontae Benson.
You're talking out inside the tackle box and outside. How about that? That's as balanced as it gets at attacking pit.
First down for the Yellow Jackets is Kervontae Benson. What a first half that young man had. Came into the game with a total of 150 yards. He's approaching 100, as Dave mentioned, although on that play, cut down after
about 215-pounder. Well, he's tough to get on the ground.
Benson again, North Carolina. Here we go with fourth and one. Georgia Tech back at it.
Tech move.
Flags are out.
False start. Offense, number 53. 5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
There's also a statue of John Heisman, who coached here at Georgia Tech. Bobby Dodd had a 31-game unbeaten streak in the early 50s as the head coach of the Jackets. Just an activity.
They can't shot.
Coach Narduzzi, he plays with his emotions on his sleeve, no question. Or coaches his emotions on his sleeve, and his team feeds off of him.
Down state, the team they played in their first game of the year and beat him in overtime, 28-21. 4 of 9 on third down for Georgia Tech, and that stat will improve thanks to Kervontae Benson.
What Pitt has done a good job of, those, they've rotated personnel up front. Hopefully that'll, for them and their fans, it'll pay dividends for them.
First and 10, Georgia Tech. Marshall ran into his own man and then tackled at the 42-yard line.
Probably gone.
Second down and 8. Benson looks like he's got the first down.
Pine, number 36, one of their linebackers. He had foot on, had ice on his foot during halftime, and he's not expected to return.
DJ, thank you. This is a run inside the 20.
In the middle for a first down.
His sixth carry of the season. They spotted at the 20. First and 10. We got it again, much less this time around. Georgia Tech, 2 for 2 in the red zone with a couple of touchdowns this afternoon. 21-17, their lead. Weimer-Skirch, eyes for the goal line, and he's in! Touchdown, Quade!
Compared to the rest of them.
Seventh year, it has taken place in Charlotte, North Carolina, Bank of America Stadium. Now the 13th time they've contested the championship game in the Atlantic Coast Conference. Benson crosses the 20 and falls forward to the 20.
He's out there banging.
He's got 133 yards rushing, a career high for a single game for Benson. This play, whistled dead.
False start, offense, number 53, 5-yard penalty.
He's hanging around at the Gatorade coolers the last time we saw him down there, Dave.
That's a good spot to be.
86 degrees here in Atlanta, much warmer on the field, the shot just told us.
Clemson, a good one.
Don't forget also Duke and Wake Forest, both undefeated at 3-0. By the way, NC State leads 2013 against Florida State. Ricky June on the catch. He goes up the sidelines near midfield. 28 yards on that play, the third catch of the game for Ricky June, the senior from Spring Valley, New York. Back to Benson.
June to catch that football.
On second down now for Georgia Tech. Did that ball come out? It appeared that Pittsburgh covered right away. Jackets from their own 21. They've got the 28-17 lead. Pittsburgh has won 4 of the last 6 meetings between the teams. That includes the last 2 on late field goals. Daquan Marshall on the carry. Last win in the series for Paul Johnson at Georgia Tech. 2014, they won at Pittsburgh, 56-28. Benson running with people hanging.
And they kind of wander up, they walk up, and then they snap it.
Play clock. Almost ran out. That was really close. So this is J.J. Green.
And a good job by Pitt to defend. And that dude get too cute there.
First turnover of the game for Pittsburgh at a critical juncture. Marshall diving over the right side and inside against the Orange. They meet next week. Will NC State survive Tallahassee with the upset bid. They lead 20-13 late in the third quarter. J.J. Green. Four players converge on Green.
8 minutes gone in the quarter. That's what Pitt's fighting right now. They've got to find a way to get off the field right here.
Marshall. Searcy. Puts the shoulder down at the 15-yard line.
Only 180 pounds, folks. 5'10", 180. Part of a 6'5 man.
He's got two rushing touchdowns in the game. That's going to be Benson.
It's going to be the touchdowns.
Marshall trying to stretch it out with a stiff arm, diving for the five.
Here, you're going to have to stop him again, because you can bet Paul Johnson going to run this, try to run this one in.
Third and short. Did the ball come out? Pittsburgh says they got it back, and they did. A fumble.
Zero for Pitt.
Best rushing offense in the country, Georgia Tech. Benson breaks away. Second level, down the sideline. Benson into the end zone. Touchdown, Georgia. Hamburgers and 40 fancy milkshakes. So Marshall out of the game. And Jay Jones is in there for Georgia Tech.
Now this kid's got great speed. We talk about Taquan Marshall's speed. This guy has probably got another gear. Just doesn't have
his team, the eventual national champs, all they could handle in that title game. Virginia Tech is trying to move to 4-0. They're playing Old Dominion today. Have an early 3-0 lead. Quarterback escapes the pocket. Up near that first down. Rushing touchdowns for Benson. Did have that one fumble. Deep in Pittsburgh territory, redeemed himself with a 47-yard TD run right after that one. Georgia Tech got the ball back.
Number 70, 5-yard penalty.
Each time the each time Georgia Tech's defense came in and forced the three and out.
Couple of sacks by Antonio Simmons. This is Jordan hustling around the corner, not afraid of some contact at the 30.